So many colors in the rainbow. So many colors in the morning sun. So many colors in the flower. And I see everyone.
Assalamu alaikum.
Read, read, read Quran just to please Allah. If you understand his words, your home will read Jannah. No, no, no prophets, just...
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, children. Welcome back. Today, we will be continuing from where we left off about Khadija radiallahu anha. Remember, if you missed the previous story time, it will be linked in the description box below. We will continue today from The Caravan Returns to Mecca. The Prophet ﷺ went on this trip to Syria accompanied by Khadija radiallahu anha's servant Maysara. They traveled a long distance and reached Syria, and then the Prophet ﷺ traded in the market of Syria with caution and intelligence. They made a big profit and returned to Mecca after traveling again for many days. When the caravan from Syria returned to Mecca, Khadija radiallahu anha was amazed to see the Prophet her caravan had made thanks to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
What is this dua?
This is a dua that we recite when we are traveling. Repeat after me, Hafa. Allahumma.
Allahumma.
Hawwin alayna.
Hawwin alayna.
Hada safara.
Hada safara.
Wadwi anna.
Wadwi anna.
Bu'da.
Bu'da.
Allahumma.
Allahumma.
أنت الصاحب
أنت صاحب
في السفر
في السفر
والخليفة
والخليفة
في الأهل
في الأهل.
It means, O Allah, make this journey easy for us and roll up its distance from us. O Allah, you are my companion in the journey and protector in my home. Khadija radiallahu anha was greatly impressed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's honesty and trustworthiness. Maysara, Khadija radiallahu anha's slave, also praised the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He told Khadija radiallahu anha, "I have never met anybody more honest or more trustworthy than Abu Talib's nephew." Do you know the best woman of paradise is Maryam bint Imran, and the best woman of the world is Khadija radiallahu anha? The marriage of Khadija radiallahu anha. Nufaysa went back to Khadija radiallahu anha after getting the consent of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his uncle Abu Talib to the marriage. Khadija radiallahu anha then asked her uncle Amr ibn Asad to marry her to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. With great joy, he agreed to this, and all the family members of Khadija radiallahu anha came to the marriage. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with his uncles Abu Talib and Hamza and his other family members. They were welcomed by Khadija radiallahu anha's uncle Amr ibn Asad and her cousin Waraqa ibn Nawfal. Many other men and women from the Quraysh, as well as from the other tribes of Mecca, took part in the marriage. The marriage became a good occasion for family and friends to get together. In the presence of the family, Abu Talib read the nikah himself. In the mehr, or dower, the Prophet ﷺ gave 20 camels, which were slaughtered, and a great feast was prepared on this occasion.
What is mehr?
Good question, Hafa. The mehr is a dowry paid by the husband to his wife. It's the property of the wife to spend, invest, or save as she pleases. The Prophet ﷺ's foster mother, Halima Sadia, was also present at this marriage.
Read, read, read Quran just to please Allah. If you understand his words, your home will read Jannah.
Let's continue with the family of Khadija radiallahu anha. After the marriage, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Khadija radiallahu anha lived at the house of Abu Talib for a few days. Then, Khadija radiallahu anha bought a house from her nephew, Hakim ibn Hizam, and they moved there. There were many people who lived with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Khadija radiallahu anha in their home. They were like one big family. There was Umme Ayman, the old maid of Amina radiallahu anha, who brought him up after his mother died. There was Zayd ibn Haritha radiallahu anha, a slave Khadija radiallahu anha gave him to her husband to help him with his work. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam immediately freed him and treated him like his own son. Zayd ibn Haritha radiallahu anhu loved the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam so much that when his own family came to take him back home, he refused to be parted from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and stayed on with him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Khadija radiallahu anha had 6 children, 2 boys and 4 girls. Both the boys Qasim and Abdullah died when they were very small babies. That's all for today, children. Inshallah, we will continue next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Assalamu alaikum.
Just to please Allah, if you understand His words, your home will be Jannah. No.